United Arab Emirates, celebrating its 49th National Day. The next 50 years starts here. Happy UAE National Day.
And I hope wherever you are across the UAE, you're having a lovely, lovely National Day, because it's such beautiful weather. It literally is picture perfect. Totally gorgeous. Blue sky, a few fluffy clouds, the sun is out. And I noticed as we were driving into work, I don't know whether you noticed it, Has, but literally it feels like the UAE is at play. I come through the lovely back roads of Sharjah coming to the studio, and everyone's playing cricket. I had to stop three or four times because the car nearly got hit twice by a cricket ball. And I just thought it was lovely. Everyone was out and in all different forms of attire as well, wearing super different things. You had sort of Western things like me, and there were jeans and t-shirts, and then there were thobes. I just thought it was lovely as I headed into the studio for work. 23 minutes past five. It's Yalla Home, of course, but it's a pleasure to be here because we have a show full of guests. But let's talk about National Day.
You know, what's interesting is obviously I'm from Saudi Arabia. I've been here 4 years and a half now. And, you know, I was on my social media today talking about how this is all home, and the UAE is home for 200 plus nationalities.
Yeah.
It seems that we are very big on diversity and, you know, obviously and acceptance and tolerance and all that. And I think this is a very unique situation that we're all in. The way 2020 has been going on, I don't need to tell you, it's been kind of going down.
Yeah.
people talk about 2021. I don't know how 2021 will be, but I know how 2020 is and was. And you feel like how the UAE handled the COVID-19 early on in the year, and how it protected its citizens and, you know, its residents. So to all the residents and the citizens in the UAE right now celebrating this, try to think about it and give back to the country that gave so much. For me, this is what I did today. You know, I just, everybody I see, I'm like, happy National Day, happy National Day.
Yeah.
And it's one common thing. And to be honest with you, and I think people take it for granted, we say it's ni'mat al-amn wal-aman bil arabi. It's like the security that we have in the country in terms of, like, you know, you can go out at 3 a.m. in the morning
and
you're secure.
Fine.
You're good.
You're safe, yeah.
It doesn't happen in a lot of places. And I don't mean Arab countries, well, Western countries. Like, it's very hard to go out at 3 a.m. in the morning anywhere in the world and you feel safe.
Yeah, you should be careful. don't do that in London. Well, I mean, you can. Mm. You just need to have your wits about you.
Yeah.
Do you know what, Has? It's funny because I was thinking today, obviously the 1st of December and the 2nd of December is the start of, you know, sort of quite a few celebrations for the West. And certainly for me and my family, and there's a lot of traditions and things like that. So today for us was tree day. Mm. We went to get a tree and decorate it. Big deal for the kids.
You got the tree today?
I got the tree today.
Oh, wow, decorated today.
I did, and decorating it today. And there's lots of things that go with it. There's certain foods that go with it. There was mince pies, and there is a special cake, a fruit cake with icing.
Wow.
There's all sorts of amazing, and the kids get so excited. Yesterday was the calendar that they get, and when they open a door every day through till the end of December, there's a small chocolate, which they love. When I was a kid, there wasn't chocolates, but there is now. and all these things were happening. But every year when we have Tree Day, I am also celebrating National Day.
Yeah.
So because we've been here 10 years, my kids, that's what they know. That's what they know and what they feel. So National Day is also Tree Day for us. And I suddenly thought, this is incredible, because this is a complete merge of cultures.
Yeah.
And this is how we are now as a family. We are completely merged. And as a family also, we've got South Africa there, we've got Irish. I'm very English, but my parents are both Northern. Right. I'm half Scottish.
Irish.
So... yeah, that's from
so cool.
Daddy's
side. Oh,
from
nice.
My kid's daddy's side. Yeah.
Ah, sweet.
So actually, there's such a merge of cultures. And it really struck me today as I'm preparing for our show to celebrate the 49th National Day. And it is National Day. It was also Tree Day. We went and got the tree. We were all in the car. We were playing the music that goes with it. It was lovely. So a real
merge.
A merge of cultures.
You've been here 10 years right now, crossing 10 years.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just really, really beautiful. And, you know, we both want to shout out, of course, Sharjah Broadcast Authority for giving us the platform to kind of make history. You are listening to us right here on Pulse 95, which is obviously Sharjah's first and only English radio station.
Yeah.
It's really cool, really been fantastic, and lots of things to talk about and do across, obviously, you know, the many years that we have. So, yeah, I mean, it is special celebrating the National
Day. Yeah.
We will be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
Yalla Home with Ella Schofield and Big Hass.
And here we are, 5:45 on Yalla Home, Big Hass and Anna Schofield. Very exciting shows over the next 3 days because we filled them full of artists, performers, DJs, Oh, goodness. Everything you can possibly think of, but also producers. So we have the great honor of being able to introduce AY.
Yeah, AY is one of those people, you know, Ayham Homsi, AY the producer on Instagram. Definitely go follow him. He's somebody I've known in from Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. Fun fact is, Ayham produced my first radio show ever.
Did he really?
Ever. Went to his place, recorded my first show. It was, I think, for the American Forces or whatever it is. And he was the guy who kind of recorded the whole thing. And just before we get him on, I'm proud of what they were able to achieve as Harmony. They have a collective called Harmony, H-R-M-N-Y, with his brother, you know, Moh Flow, which we play his music all the time.
We got
Jeed, we got Mind Circus, and it's just an amazing collective, and it's from the artists, by the artists, really. And they're really expanding and doing a lot of work in the UAE and in the region as well, to be honest. So we're very, very happy and honored to have AY with us. So we're going to say salam alaikum, Ayham.
What's going on, guys? Thank you for having me.
Such
happy
a pleasure.
Happy National Day to everybody.
Happy National Day.
Happy National Day.
Yo, God bless, man. You know, stalking you on Instagram, you're in somewhere, I don't know where you are, like camping. Where are you? You're in Khorfakan.
Well, I went to Ras Al Khaimah earlier with my family, and now I'm in Khorfakan. I'm kind of like enjoying the UAE today, you know, kind of in honor of the National Day.
And the weather is just beautiful, isn't it? So you really picked a good day to do it.
It's a beautiful, I mean, this is the right time.
Yeah.
If I tell anyone who's visiting the UAE, like, this is the right time where you should come right now.
Yeah, 100%. AY, listen, يعني زي ما يقولوا شهادتي فيك مجروحة. I don't know how to explain that in English.
English,
but it's
people,
more like it's more like, no matter what I say, I can't give this guy credit because you've really done incredible work. For people who don't know AY, tell us briefly, in a really brief way, how did your passion for production come about?
It started really early on when I was like 14 years old. I just found the software and I wanted to make music. Initially, I wanted to be an artist, and then I figured out that I really like working with other artists and developing them. And that's how it kind of kicked off, you know?
Okay.
But you're 14 years old.
14 years old. You know what? My son's just turned 14. So as you said that, I thought, wow, you were that focused at that age. Because, I mean, my son doesn't know what he wants to do in any shape or form. So that's incredible focus. So you're one of those artists then, or rather producers, that just has music through to the core. Your brother, you do a lot of production for your brother, don't you? Moh Flow.
I work with Moh Flow. I work with Michelle. I work with
Adam.
We just released
Adam
the
Nabil.
Yeah.
The Layla Kardan,
Layla Kardan.
New songs that just came out. I produced them as well. You know, I worked early on with Hamza Hosawi. You know, it's been a few artists here and then. I've done some records for TLC as well, the No Scrubs group.
Wow.
Their later albums as well. Yeah, so I've been making music for a while. And apart from that, obviously, we have Harmony, which is actually a creative agency in Saudi and in Dubai. And we work with great entities like DED and NEOM and Expo and DFF. And we do all their social media.
I think this
work.
Is what this is what also makes you guys kind of unique. You're obviously artists, you're releasing music, but you're also getting in touch the business element of things. And I know you're very adamant about that. You're always focused on that, which is really incredible. Listen, I got to ask you this real quick. In your opinion, what's the major difference between a producer and a beat maker? As somebody who's done production for a while,
I think most producers start off as beat makers, and sometimes they don't really transition. But the majority of the difference is that a producer is someone who executes part of the job. A producer is someone who delivers an entire idea or concept. So a beat maker could be part of your arsenal. It could be someone as in part of your team. But a producer doesn't necessarily execute everything himself, but he helps bring the whole thing together. It's more of like a director or of a movie rather than just someone who is a producer or an editor or someone that's playing a role in it, but
True.
Someone who helps bring the whole thing home from start to finish.
And you do that wonderfully, man. Like, you know, we're about to actually play Wave by Moh Flow.
Yeah.
Not the remix,
I think you should play Holiday, actually. Just,
you want to play Holiday? Be my guest. We'll definitely do that. I'll put it on the system.
He's going to put it in right now. Let's talk about the UAE and your love of it. And also, Hass is very passionate about trying to find the UAE sound. He was literally speaking to Spotify about it yesterday because he gets very passionate is the best word. Furious is also another word, AY, but he gets very passionate about saying the UAE needs its own sound. You know, stop bringing in artists from abroad. Let's have our own sound. Where do you sit on that?
I'm not really against bringing people from outside of the UAE, but I'm also against not developing enough talent within the UAE.
Yeah.
I think the region has a very cool aesthetic. I think we're cool. I think Arabs are cool. I think we can make amazing music. And I think there's a problem with boxing our regional talent into just regional borders where they're unable to cross over into the rest of the world. And I think you have incredible people that are based here. The one, people like Michelle, like Leila, like Jamie DeVille is doing amazing stuff. You have Free Cairo. You have Subhi. You know, you have Majid. You have Moh Flow. You have Adam Nabeel. Like, the list can go on. It's artists that are just doing. You have Freak, who's absolutely breaking borders and doing amazing things as well. So,
yeah, I love Freak.
I think, I, to be honest, since Anna brought it up, it's not about having the sound. It's about, you know, the reason why we're talking about this is top 10 streamed artists in the UAE were like BTS, the your Justin Bieber's and all that.
Taylor Swift.
None of it we're representing. And that's okay, because when you go to Morocco, you'll still find, but you'll find out that there are some Moroccans. When you go to Egypt, you'll find out that Wegs, who's a rapper, just surpassed Amr Diab, who's one of the biggest artists in the world for 40 years or whatever. So this is, and I think the diversity is the sound, like the fact that we have 200 plus nationalities in the UAE. I don't think it's hard to break that through, but it's people like you, like the fact that you're going to merge, that Middle Eastern vibe with that, which is a question to you now, AY. What can you tell us about the next kind of records Mo is dropping? Because, you know, I know that you guys are working so hard.
Come on, give us
we have really amazing songs. We have really amazing collaborations with artists from Nigeria, from artists from the U.S., from artists from Morocco, from in Saudi. So we've been working on a bunch of different sounds and music. And obviously, we've been writing really interesting music where Mo is actually delivering lyrics in Arabic, which is really fun for us, because we're trying to do it and keep his sort of like integrity as an artist and his sound, which has been a really interesting thing that we're tackling. But we have amazing music coming up. We're definitely dropping every 2 or 3 weeks for the next year and a half. So
that's dope.
Music coming around.
That's a blessing, man. Listen, last question is, you've been here in the UAE. Today we're celebrating the 49th National UAE Day. What does the UAE mean to Ayham?
The UAE has been home for me and my family for 15 years now plus. It has hosted us. It's been kind to us. It's been beautiful for everyone. It's been great for our businesses. It's just been a place that we were able to sort of dream and make our dreams a possibility. So we love the UAE, and honestly, like, it's home to us. Jeddah's home as well, but
Jeddah.
UAE has been an amazing home for us.
Yeah, but
as
the UAE loves you back, man. Listen, I'm going to flip the thing, flip the roles right here. You're going to introduce the holiday song, okay?
Okay.
You're the radio host. Hey, go ahead.
All right, I want to introduce Moh Flow to you guys. This song is called Holiday. I hope you guys are chilling and having an amazing time with your loved ones. Happy National Day to everybody.
Yalla Home. And Big House.
Happy, happy, happy is the word. 6:08. Thanks for joining us here at Yalla Home. Anna Schofield and Big House. But we are not alone. It's Yalla Live tonight. And through till 7 o'clock, we have the most amazing comedy duo. Well, man and wife, not necessarily a comedy duo.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Ali Yaseida and Mina Liccione.
Yay!
Yay!
Woo! So exciting.
We started right.
There it is. She's calling the tribe, you guys.
Yo. Salam. Ahlan wa sahlan. Hello, ghala. Big up. Much real love and respect to you guys. Thank you so much for blessing us today with your presence.
Yeah. Yeah, marhababak, man. It's a pleasure to be here, finally. Although this building is like a treasure hunt. It was incredible.
It is. I mean, you know. Not unless you use Google Map, at least say it.
Yeah. No, we got to the building fine. It's once you enter the building.
Yes.
Oh,
okay.
It's a treasure house. Yeah. Where's Spooks? They were like, good luck. We will pay for you.
Inshallah, you will be there.
Yeah. He's like, what time you need to be there? 6. Oh, it's tight, brother.
Yo, man. But again, thank you guys for making it. God bless you guys. And, you know, we've been looking forward to this for the past couple of weeks since we talked about it.
And it was quite funny, because actually when we were told that we were doing these live shows, and they said to us, right, we want you to, you can choose your own guests, which is a gift, obviously. So we're very excited about that. And we literally hit up all our best friends, because a pair of us are just, you know, whether it's musicians or actors or performers. And then on the first day, he sent an email, just as I'd already emailed you, to our marketing director saying, and I've spoken to Mina and Ali. And I was like, so have I. So we literally sent to you, the first email we both sent out was to you guys individually and separately.
Well, I want to thank you for having us on the drive home show on a day that no one's driving home at this time. This is really...
Yo,
Anna, I told you. Name.
I haven't replied to that. We can go all crazy.
Yeah, I'm go hard, Has. Go
Yo,
hard.
We have one... Just for you to know, Ali, we have one of the biggest YouTube channels. Like, everyone
yes.
watching us right now.
You're on it. Look at you.
Look at Mina.
Mina's right there. Close up on Mina.
Oh, man.
All right, can we get into it in
yeah.
terms
yeah,
of...
Yeah, let's
obviously,
do it.
So, the backstory, and Has, you'll be far more... You can elaborate on the backstory. Mm. I know them as comedians that I was introduced to by a comedian friend of mine literally about 6 months, a year ago. And she gave me the backstory of these two are incredible. Now, I'm obviously talking about Rebecca Howe, who is a UAE comedian. She's been here 2 years and she said, they're just amazing, Anna, honestly. And Mina is from America and Ali is Emirati and they're this and they're that. And I was like, wow. And then, of course, I saw you both perform. But it goes much further back. You obviously run to Bomedy and you've known them for years.
You know, when I was in Saudi Arabia, me and Ali and Mina connected because of our love for hip-hop, actually, and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, we're hip-hop heads.
Yeah, man, hip-hop. Wow. I just want you to get closer a little bit to the mic, Mina.
Oh, okay.
Get right
yeah,
in.
We need
all
to
right,
hear that lovely
no
voice.
No one's ever
no
said
one
that
is
to Mina.
Ever. Yeah, no. They're usually like, can you back it up? Can you tone it down a little bit? Yeah.
Now you know.
I'm loud. I don't even need a microphone.
They'll hear her.
Yeah, no, shut up. So it was on, actually, Facebook messages back then. If you still use Facebook messages, big up to you. But it was like that, yeah. And to be honest with you, and I said that in the intro, you were like true representation of the region. You really were breaking stereotypes. Those clips that you guys used to do or still do as well, it's just funny. So just to both of you, like Mina, how did this whole comedy, love for comedy and making a difference start? I'll start with you, Mina, and then go to Ali.
It's my dad. That's
right.
It.
God
That's
bless.
The heart of it. Yeah, my dad's really, really funny. And apparently the story they tell is that I was a really, really shy kid.
Wow.
But I loved to dance and sing at home. So they put me in dance class and I in his voice. And she hasn't shut up since. Mud on.
God bless him.
Okay.
And that was it. That's it. Ever since three, I knew. It
Bam.
Chose me. There was nothing else.
Comedy gave you a voice as well. It seems like you were saying that you were a shy person now.
Yes.
Obviously, you're like, you know.
Yeah.
Shy. Sorry, did you say shy?
She said, like, she was, you know.
Oh, for the first 3 years.
For the first 3 years,
But that's not
it
a
was
good...
dance, theater, comedy, everything kind of just, it
but
was
I
a
see
form
it.
Of expression. It came right out.
That's the beautiful thing about art. What about you, Ali?
Well, I have a hard time explaining to people that I'm a comedian. when I first started, nobody believed me. No, it's the truth.
Really? Yeah.
And even today, like, if there's, like, a restaurant or cafe that I'm a regular at, and even the staff there, when they find out that I do comedy, they're like, but sir, you're very aggressive. You don't talk like you're a comedian.
Shut up.
And I don't know. I have a face makes people not believe that I'm funny. But
actually, it's the other way around with me. It's your face that... Look at me right now. Look at this. Come on. I crack up. I can't.
I suppose you are slightly scary.
Drove all the way to Sharjah to get insulted.
Yeah.
This guy. It's like your face. That's what's funny about
you. It's the whole thing, you know? It's so weird that people... Yeah, man. But God bless. What has been so challenging doing comedy in the UAE?
You know, it's funny because the UAE is very transient, right? So every couple of years, the audience changes and... it's a different flock of people that come here that you're also catering to, which is fun. It's a lot of fun, I gotta say. But you know, since having kids, I've been doing this joke about how stupid my son is, and and then so people have been messaging me lately and saying, how dare you call your son stupid?
Oh.
I'm like, I'm an Arab dad. That is like one of two privileges I have. What are you talking about?
Right. Goes with the territory.
We were talking about this yesterday. See, the things that you discuss as, like, sometimes you break barriers.
Yeah.
You talk about things that no one wants to
and
talk
you said
about.
That. Right.
You know, that's comedy, though. Yeah. Mina, with you, as a duo, when you guys, like, rock stage together, how is that like? Sometimes you know, you'd be before Ali be before you and stuff like that.
Mm.
How is that vibe? Do you prepare, like, content together, material together? Take us through, like, a...
Nah, well, the thing is, I love it. I love it. If he's hosting, first of all, I'm so excited because I know this guy is going to bring the crowd up.
Big time.
I know when I walk onto that stage, they are going to be like in the zone.
Yeah.
And it's amazing. It's a gift. So I get to walk into the zone already there.
Right.
And then vice versa. You know what I mean? Like, he knows, all right, if she's hosting and she's setting the stage for me, I can walk right in.
Right.
And we never, the first, whoever's performing first, we never reveal we're married. The second person does.
Okay.
Because wow. then they're going to be thinking about it, imagining the you know. But yeah. a lot of people know we're married already.
Yeah.
But I love it when, you know, I'll do all these jokes, and then he comes out and he's like, yeah, by the way, that's my wife. And there's just a, oh. And he's yeah. like, now you get to hear my side of the story.
Oh, wow.
Amazing.
So it's kind of like these two different versions. But I love getting to perform with him. And the beauty of comedy is, like, it's point of view.
Yeah.
We live Fact. Together. We have the same kids. We can talk about the same trip. But his version is always slightly different. He's observing yeah. it in different
oh,
ways.
I thought she was going to say funnier.
Sometimes.
I want to know, how did you meet? How did you two meet?
Mm. AmericanWife.com.
There's two different, yeah, there's two different versions to that story, too.
Yo, bro,
yeah.
you should
AmericanWife.com. Big Hoss is like, well, no, I am allowed otherwise. Big, maybe, yeah. let me Google that.
Yeah. He's like, wait a minute. Yeah,
by
the website exists, okay. Yeah.
He's like, if it doesn't, let me buy that domain See, right
I'll,
now.
I'll tell you when it's, like, super awkward yeah. is when she reveals that I'm her husband at the beginning of her jokes.
Okay.
And then yeah. she does jokes about me for an hour. So you have the audience looking at me after every joke like, is that true? Is that what you did?
They'll be like this.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Judgmental. And then I have to go up and, you know. What are you going to do, man?
No, actually, the first time I saw you, that was me, I have to say, because I knew you were married, and your set had a lot of him in it.
Oh, yeah.
And I was the girl that was doing the shifty eyes going, oh, really?
Oh, man.
Art yeah. reflects life, man. That's, I'm a storyteller, so
Love
he
it.
Knew that. That's the beauty, too, of our marriage, is like, he knew once we were married, we were both like, all right, it's yeah. going to happen.
It goes yeah, bright
yeah,
as
yeah. We know.
Man.
It's inevitable, so we're cool with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, you guys are breaking barriers. If you have any questions for Ali and Mina, please feel free to send it through right now. 4215, it's a lot or do. We will be right back.
Yalla Home with Ella Schofield and Big Hass.
Thank you for joining us here at Yalla Home. It's Yalla Live. We are joined by two amazing guests. They're both comedians, married couple, Mina and Ali. In fact, you may have seen them here in the UAE. The fact that we managed to persuade them to come in live on National Day is something that's quite remarkable and incredible. Turns out they're old friends of Big Hass's. Mm. I want to go personal before we get into anything else with them. I want to know you've I do
questions, you guys, before we do that, questions,
have you got questions on that?
We okay. do have a couple of questions, but go in and 4215 it's a lot or do okay. any questions you have for Ali and Mina, we will definitely ask.
We will ask them, keep yeah. it clean. All right, so personal. So you're both performers. Come you're both on, comedians, not just performers. You've just Come had on, twins. Man. How old are the twins?
They just turned three.
Did they?
Yes, wow. like 2 days wow. ago.
Yeah.
Well, what's really sad, like, okay, first of all, it's like everyone's like, oh, you're sad because it's gone so fast. Mm. What I'm really sad about is no more free for under three.
Okay. You know what I'm saying? Now we got to pay for these guys?
Yeah. And I'm like, oh, we can't fake the funk. One of them is so tall. His nickname is Taller Swift. He is taller than Kevin Hart, y'all.
Can I be honest?
Like, this, we can't fake it.
Yo, this is something we always think about. That's what I'm saying with the comedy.
Oh, my gosh.
With the flight situation, right?
Like, yeah, flights get
now,
expensive.
After, what's the second age after 10, they increase?
Yeah,
right?
12. Sometimes it's yeah. 10, sometimes it's 12. So,
as soon as they hit 12, you're paying for everything.
They already have mustaches. They look 12. I'm three. What am I going to do?
On another note, we're selling a couple of twins.
Oh, God.
On AmericanWife.com.
On AmericanWife.com.
Yeah, no,
there it is.
AmericanChild.com.
Come on, man.
Oh.
Amazing. So is there any plans for more twins?
We're good, thanks.
No, you're done now?
I'm good.
Okay.
Yes, Mina jumped on this before and finished.
We're good.
Is that true, Ali? Are you done? Yeah.
Listen, definitely with Mina last, but, you know, I'm talking to my other wives. Let's see what happens.
Okay. This is good.
You never know.
No, you never know.
But we're good for now.
Are you taking the equipment
apart?
But you
never know. Hey.
I'm just loving this because the whole thing, see, you guys, I know I'm the serious type, sorry.
Right.
But you're witnessing it right now. It happens in, it's like people think a certain thing about this part of the world and right. this region especially. And that's why their work is crucially important. Right. You know, I'm not saying it. Very important because that's how you break the barriers.
Yeah.
Like, that's how you destroy
yeah.
those stereotypes and whatever and
yeah.
and everything, which is, I mean, you have so many fans. What was the sort of feedback from one of the fans about this topic, about changing perception? About like, oh, I thought it was like this. It turned out to be like this. Whether it's from Mina or Ali.
Like from a fan?
From a fan perspective, coming in and saying, oh, wow. Like, you know, I really had a different idea of how things are here, but it turned out to be like that.
Well, I always get backhanded compliments. Like when people like after a show, I'm like, oh my God, you're so funny for a local.
And I get the same thing though every now and then.
Is that a fact?
You're so funny for a woman.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you also get that. I've never really liked the women. They're a bit manly who are funny. But you're pretty and funny, mashallah. So really? It's like, oh, okay.
That's how we met.
Okay.
That's the first time.
Right.
That's what I said. No.
That was my
pickup line.
But also, I mean, just on this topic, when we really feel it, because now it's like we never take it for granted, like being able to break a stereotype or talk about, like we love to make people laugh, but then make people think.
Exactly.
Like, we love that. Yeah. And when we go back to the States, that's when we really feel like, talk about it. He performed at the Muslim Funny Fest in Manhattan.
With Dean?
And this is right Dean? After with Dean Abdullah. And we're in, he was just like, I'm going to wear my Kandora.
Yeah.
And this was right after a gentleman was beat up in a Kandora in a States.
Oh, no.
And we were there and we were in the lobby and everyone is staring at Ali. Like everyone is just like staring at him and he's like, let's call an Uber. Please let it be Muhammad. Please let it be Muhammad.
I know it's going to be Muhammad. That's why I went an Uber.
But it was really intense. And then we get there and there's all these like police, there's like security outside the comedy club that night.
Oh,
and
wow.
When Ali went in there and he just called it out, and that first laugh, it was, I say, no pun intended, but it was explosive.
Right.
Like, to see him.
You intended for that pun.
Yeah.
A little bit. But it was so powerful to see him in this completely different
beautiful.
Environment and that really going. And then on the flip side, having a New Yorker come, you know, from New York, going to Dubai, coming back, doing jokes about my Muslim Arab husband to a group of very non-Muslims.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was great. People afterwards have questions. It started a dialogue.
A conversation, which is important.
Which so is how I felt. Is it safe to go to Dubai? Is it this? Is it that? Wow, so your husband, were you forced to convert is the number one question I get.
Wow.
And I get this opportunity
to say
be
yes,
like,
I was.
Yes. Yes.
Bro, this is why I love you guys. Because these are the things that, you know, you have this set where you talk about the if you see something, say something.
Right.
Yes.
Like
right.
That's so funny, but yet you know very it's like right there. If you're addressing really important things, and that one right there, what you just said, Mina, is also crucially important. And that's why you guys, when you do comedy, when you write your material, you think about this is the outcome that you wanna.
I mean,
project.
Look, sometimes yes and sometimes no, but, you know, that if you see something, say something comes from a discomfort. You know, when I go to the U.S., which is where my wife is from, I spend up to 8 hours in holding until they can clear me and I can go through.
Do you really?
I've been in the brown room, people. I'm married to him now, so
She's seen it.
Yes.
So by default, you end up there too.
Well, she does. She can go.
Since I'm married to an Arab, I'm ABM now.
Oh,
Arab
wow.
by misery, y'all.
Wow, it's so weird. I wanted to ask you, and when you just talked about, Hass can barely speak, when you just talked about that situation where Ali's standing in reception in his thobe and everyone is staring at him, everyone in the theatre, and you're like, oh, this is, okay. But what does go through your head as his wife? Do you feel protective? Do you move away from him?
Yeah.
Do you like, what's your reaction?
No, I'm super protective. I'm Italian, New Yorker to begin with. So I was
the
super.
The mafia showed up.
Oh, No. I was
with us, okay.
I was looking back. I New Yorkers were confrontational. I don't shy away from confrontation.
Love that.
I look him in the eye. I'm
what's
like,
up?
What can I do for you?
You want
How
a piece
you
of
going?
Me.
You good? What you doing? Hey. Like the New Yorker comes like my dad and my family come really out. So yes, I right. come
it'll be like this for Nina. Mina. Let's go. Hey.
Come in, ladies and gentlemen.
She saw that.
Yeah, we're doing it. LL Cool J.
Now, if you're watching us live on Pulse 95, you'll be able to see us on YouTube.
Actually,
you cannot bust out some LL Cool J. Excuse me, ladies love
true.
Cool James.
Oh, man.
Without a dance. Sorry, y'all.
No, 100%. You know, I had the pleasure to talk to LL Cool J.
Dude, that was dope.
What's
Can
that?
We just say that
we
was man?
Saw that. Yes, you saw that. That was.
That was like it was incredible, man.
Yeah.
And the thing that he said, to be honest, diverting a little bit from this, but he said, "I want to hear like you know we're talking about hip hop. I want to hear Arab rappers in their own language."
Yeah. Yes.
Which is something that you know, which again brings me to this topic: people who are Arab, Emiratis, who do like stand-up comedy in English or. Does the language matter, Ali? I'm talking about, you know, about you. A lot of people maybe would say, oh, he does a lot of English, you know, you do it in English, obviously.
Right.
Do they have to do it in Arabic to break the stereotype? And what do you think about that?
So I do both, but I don't do them equally. So the reality is this, right? When you put out, when you depend on live shows and a live audience to be there, then you have to, you know, read the crowd. So sometimes, you know, there's not going to be enough people that come to Arabic shows.
Yeah.
Right.
And that's something that we're trying to change. But I will say language is a lot more important if it's a pre-recorded situation. If you're, you know, if you're a musician, a lot of these artists. And I love that Arabic hip hop is really changing right now.
Yeah. I see you, man. Thank you for the support. You always show love to me personally
man.
And to many.
Of course. But there was a point and I was very interested early on to do what you did, but I never had the stamina that you had, is because it was horrible at first. You know, they're talking about, you know, the gangs and the what. I'm like, bro,
there's no West Side and East Side
here,
bro.
Dinner that your mom made.
It's just Middle East.
Yeah. A fact.
The Midwest.
But that's part of the education. It's the same thing with stand-up comedy, to be honest.
Right.
You're doing it, bro. Seriously, you guys are doing it. I'm telling you, I am in the pulse. I know what it is. People talk about, especially stand-up comedians, when anyone comes here, it's like, you know, you guys, done, khalas, that's it. And I think that's truly important. You're able to achieve that.
Thank you, man. We do our part, you do your part, and we push this culture forward, man.
Yeah. Mm.
So what's the plan now? You obviously run to Bomedy. You're married. You have the twins. The twins are three. They're growing. You're doing shows all the time. Mm-hmm. And you've just finished, in fact, the festival. Mm-hmm. You just did the whole festival. And you both appeared several times. Incredible. What next?
Ukrainianwife.com.
You can play the headlines now, Hass.
No, but yeah, I mean, let's talk about what's next, but after those headlines. How about that? Yeah, let's go. Keep it like Pulse 95 Radio. Watch us on YouTube, you guys. We will be right back.
I knew he was going to do it. I was waiting. I was like, is it going to be Russian?
Yeah.
Is it going to be, you know, Nigerian?
She knows
Portuguese?
My type.
I was like, where are we going? Maybe Brazilian today.
They got to do the news.
Fade them out.
Let's go. We can be right back. Let's go.
This is Pulse 95. Pulse.
And I hope you're having a good one. 20 to 7. It's Yalla Home, of course, with Anna Schofield and Big Hass. And we're joined by Mina and Ali, two very incredible comedians, married couple as well, which sort of blows my mind a bit that you
keep
can
reminding
be
me that we're married.
I think that that's
as
the thing that sticks with me.
As if it wasn't sad enough for
no,
walking
come
in.
Come on now, Ali. You know?
I'm with Ali on this one. No, I'm kidding. Look at me.
I mean, my money would be on Mina winning that battle. I don't think you should go there.
Talking about battles, though, but we have a couple of questions, if you guys don't mind answering. Top five comedians for both Mina and Ali. This is from...
Nice.
Yomi. Okay, shout out to Yomi tuning in. Y-O-M-I. We'll start with you, Mina. Top five comedians.
Oh my gosh.
That's the list.
It's really hard for me to do like a top five because right now it's Dave Chappelle, and Dave Chappelle.
Okay.
I would add Dave Chappelle to that.
Yeah, I've loved Dave since day one. Yeah. I knew Dave back when we were teenagers in New York.
Oh my goodness, you know him.
Well, amazing. My friend dated him a long time ago, but
stop dishing out another man.
No, that's great.
And then what happened?
When he told me the story when we met, I was like, wow.
So I've always followed Dave Chappelle. I love him. We're both big fans of Chris Rock as well. And yeah. I love Michelle Wolf. I love Mohammer, Gabriel Iglesias.
Wow.
Joe Coy is doing his thing.
Joe Coy is dope.
You know, he's representing, and I love Wanda Sykes. I've loved Wanda for a long time, and you know what?
You better stop it.
I know. I would love to see her come in and do something new, but I like Wanda. That's right. I'm with Wanda.
What about you, Ali?
Yeah. Chris Rock, Dave Chappelle, Bill Burr is smashing it right now. Michelle Wolf, my boy Mohammer's dope. Mm. I mean, there's so many comics out there. It's hard to do a top five. But
we gotta mention Nimr too, our boy Nimr.
Yeah, Nimr Bonassar. I think he's which brings me to this question: when it comes to stand-up comedy and the Arab region, what are your thoughts about it? Because to be honest, I don't know where is it right now.
Yeah,
at what place?
The scene.
Yeah, you want like a happy answer, or do you want the real answer?
No, I want the very authentic, real answer.
I think our audience needs to get behind artists in general. There we go. Production in the house.
Yep.
I think what happens is a lot of people complain about there not being a scene or whatever in all disciplines, art wise. But when it comes to supporting an artist, we support. I do a bit about this, and I'm going to try not to burn it because it's one of my favorite jokes right now. But what happens is we wait for Rami Malek to win an Oscar to say, you know, he's Egyptian.
Oh, yeah.
No, he's American.
Give him the flowers before it's too late.
Right, because if he was in Egypt, they would have been like, no, you better pay attention to your studies because this is not going to take you anywhere.
Okay.
And that's a huge problem that we have. Look, Nimr is killing it. He always has. He reached to a place where, you know, no other Arab comedian from the region has done. And then he felt like, all right, I plateaued. I'm gonna go to L.A. and
Twitch all day.
And Twitch all day, basically. He's obsessed with Twitch.
He's obsessed.
The last show we did together, he's like, bro.
I know.
Bro.
I saw that.
Do they have Wi-Fi?
Nimr is a Lebanese-American stand-up comedian. It's okay. Really, really good.
Okay,
so Nimr was with me in university, in American University of Beirut.
Oh,
when I was there.
I was
also a shy kid in university. I didn't have that, you know, and then I got into hip hop, and then so Nimr was always hosting these outdoor events and outdoor AUB thing, and he always had it. So part of us from this generation that see Nimr right now successful, we go like, you know, there's always AUB students around his shows.
Right.
Yeah,
so you give hope, which in my opinion, Ali, you do that too, to be honest, to have a guy wearing the kandura, Emirati proud, and also breaking stereotypes like that. You're with this wonderful, incredible, iconic Mina Liccione. For me, when I first saw her live, the way you guys handle fans or people generally, oh my God, it's just incredible. Seriously, only time can teach that.
Yeah. The handling of fans. Is that something that you
that
talk
sounds, about? That doesn't sound right.
I think what he's trying to do is crowd work, like record.
I do not touch any of my fans.
No.
he's trying to me too us right now.
Pass,
bro.
Let me take this now.
The
you know,
crowd. Oh, God, you guys.
So as a Westerner sitting here and listening to you and Hass talk, then, so right. what I got from you is that you're not encouraged in the arts. Hass talks about this with artists. So is that what you're saying? You know, you think your culture...
No, not at all.
We're
not discouraged from the arts.
Okay.
And that's different than being encouraged in the arts. The thing is, I think our audience is... And I don't want to really, like, poke at the audience. I try not to. But our audience needs to back us up a little bit more.
Right.
Right? So they like us, they show up, that's great. But you gotta... you know, there's... All these people, you know, when they make it, you know, in the West or whatever, they got all these fans that, you know, share their stuff. They're always talking about it. They bring people to the shows or whatever.
Yeah.
The best thing our guys do here is, I know how to say it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's the extent of it.
So would you say they just don't come to the shows enough? They're not on board.
I would add to that. It's not.
Yeah.
The thing is, this
She's
is
trying
exact,
to make me say stuff, bro.
No, this is. I
want to know genuinely. Shout out
to Christina and Yanis. They're both our marketing manager and also boss. Yeah. They're tuning in, loving the conversation. By the way, you guys, but it is the same problem that we have in the music scene.
Yeah.
What he said about you got to blow up, and this is something we always talk about.
You got to
blow up outside, and then we know him, bro.
Yeah.
Give him or sis, give him or her the chance here. And it's a lot of things. It's about And I was talking about this the whole day yesterday, because it seems that the top 10 streamed artists in the UAE, none of them represent the UAE. Not even the Hassan al-Jismis, according to Spotify.
No, so it's BTS, like
Justin Bieber, Travis Scott. Not even Balqis, who's tier A, right?
And she's incredible.
Yeah. She's I love Balqis. And Hassan al-Jismi, they're not even in that list.
Wow.
So what does that even tell you? I know diversity is there, but I mean, what does that tell you about the people who are really killing it here?
I'll tell you what. When I post that I'm doing a show in New York, people will randomly just post and be like, I first met Ali when he was 40 years old. You know, like they'll always have a backstory.
Right.
I did this thing. I had a meeting with Sesame Street once, right? This was years ago.
Shout out Sesame Street.
This was in New York. And it was very like, it was more of a consultation thing. Would you work as a writer for a thing we're doing? It was just like a meeting. So on the way out, they gave me like an Elmo, I want to say. And they said, hey, take
a
picture.
Our boys have it now, yeah.
Yeah. They're like, take a picture with this iconic thing, whatever, right? So I did that, and I posted it. I'm like, hey, it's crazy. I never thought I'd be at, you know, Sesame Street. And the number of people that posted, first of all, people thought I was a writer. So everyone wrote like an essay about me. It's like, bro, I have a show on Tuesday. You want to show up?
Oh, wow.
That's what I need.
Right. So that's really interesting. So I'm reflecting that back. Obviously, our mutual comedian friend, Rebecca Howe, from the moment she started comedy, which she started with you, in the UAE, I've been to every show. I think I missed one last week.
How and that was dare it. You?
I know. There was a thing with my children. I couldn't go. I know. But if she's on stage, and it doesn't matter if I've seen her set, which I have now five times, you know, I'm there all the time. Yeah. So is that what you're saying? You want that kind of...
I'm not asking for unconditional love. That is very selfish for me to...
He doesn't even ask me for that anymore, which is amazing.
Right. UkrainianWife.com. No, so like, for you
to
say...
Iranian? Did you say
I'm
Iranian?
There to support my friend is one thing. I'm just saying that we can all do more to support each other. Like, you know, like what Haas does, man, with all these amazing musicians in our region. Like, I heard about two artists since being here.
Right. Mm.
Just by sitting down, just hanging with Haas.
Yeah.
I heard about a Libyan dude and... Forgive me, other
and
dudes.
And you let it flow over you. Yeah.
No, shout out to you, man. Mina, when it comes to, you know, like the writing process, we were talking to Rebecca yesterday. Mm. As you guys, you've been doing this for quite some time now.
Yeah.
Does it get to the level where it's she was saying that you can't go on stage unprepared or stuff like that. A lot of people freestyle. Have you ever freestyled the whole show without preparation?
It depends. It depends on the show, to be honest with you. If I'm hosting, there's more freedom.
Correct.
Right.
When you're hosting, you do something that we like to call crowd work, where you're improvising with the audience and you're going back and forth. But for me, I come from, you know, Ali and I are two very different worlds when it comes to this, but I'm a Broadway baby.
Right.
You know, I'm very disciplined. I've been dancing and training since I was three.
Because you were in Stomp, weren't you? I remember being
and it
incredible.
Was the repetition. And like Stomp, we knew the music.
Right.
But we could freestyle all of the movement and everything within. If you know the structure, you can go out freestyle and always come back to it. So that's the way I perform my stand up is that I know, okay, this is my set that I have this structure. However, if there's people in the audience that I'm vibing with or I'm going to improvise, I'm going to find the flow, but then I can always come back to the structure. So I like to have a solid set that I know before going on stage because that allows me to improvise
in a
weird way.
I think that's really amazing. I know you have a different, you know, obviously writing process, but we just approached a blessed prayer for, you know, of course, Alisha.
Yalla Home. With Ella Scofield
and Big Hass.
Women producing men go wild.
She liked that. I knew it. It's in New York. Let's go. Ali Say freestyle right here. You ready? Oh, man.
I want to video it.
In a Liccione.
Wow. It's Yalla Home. We're live through till 8 o'clock. And if you can't tell, we've got live guests. If you're watching on YouTube live, Ray, our engineer, can't actually believe what
he's saying. Shout out Ray, man. You know, Ray, Ali, Ray is from the Philippines. Mahal kita Philippines. I know you have a special connection with the brothers and sisters in Philippines.
I love Filipinos.
Yeah. Show them.
His hands in the air. Hey, Ray, dude,
you got to show.
I wish I was Filipino.
Record this. Okay.
You guys are the best at everything, and I have so much respect for just the commitment to humanity that you guys have.
Truth. 100%.
And also, you guys have a very funny president. Is it president or prime minister?
He's nodding his head, yeah.
Duterte is like the verbal version of like Manny Pacquiao.
Wow.
Did you see like he was swearing, he was talking about like the US president at the time. He's like, I don't care about Trump. I'm not scared. It's so funny.
Yeah, he's a character, man.
He is dope, man. Yeah. He does not fear anybody.
Yeah. Wow.
Brilliant. Okay.
Just loving it.
So we've obviously caught you on National Day. It would be wrong because it's National Day that's allowed us to bring you in here. Mm-hmm. And we hit you up and you came in live and that's amazing. So it would be wrong for us not to ask what National Day means to you. And obviously this is your home. The UAE is your home. It's the home of your company. It's the home of your children. It's the home of both of you. So Mina, what does it mean?
I'm all about the UAE. I love the UAE.
Yeah,
I make jokes about it and I say the UAE is a new American dream.
Because I came here. It's true.
You know, it was a huge leap of faith. You know, everyone was scared. My family were just like, I didn't mean to go into the Middle East by yourself. But something in me, is it odd or is it God? All the arrows were like, no, you need to, you're bringing comedy and you're going to meet people and you're going to follow this. You're going to follow this. So to be here, I met my boo. We have babies. We're holding it down and, you know,
you are.
Our passion is our work. So, you know, this is home and I'm safe. I'm so blessed, especially during this pandemic.
True. Yeah.
UAE handled it so well.
Didn't they?
My family in the States are really suffering and struggling. So I'm just like so blessed and so grateful. And I love the UAE. Many props. Mm. And I want to stay here for a while.
Wow.
So.
Ali, for you as an Emirati, how do you, 49, you know, mashallah, celebrating the 49th year, Allah yahfazkum, Allah yahfaz al-Imarat. Seriously, it's incredible. I call it home. I moved here from Jeddah, Saudi Arabia, for my son, who's my hero, who's autistic, and he's improving like crazy. And it is the UAE really played a big role in that because of the understanding they put on the word autism and kilmat al-tawahud nafsi. So there's a lot of, you know, all the rulers, they know about it, they push it, and the residents here. So what does that mean to you, celebrating 49 years?
I'll tell you something very interesting. There's a connection that you have with the Emirates, whether you're from here or you live here. And look, growing up, the circumstances and what this city looked like was something completely different. The whole country looked very different.
Right.
This week, I've been to like 5 Emirates. You know, just because we're doing a lot more shows now, and I've seen, you see that every one of them is different and is growing in its own way. So for me, it always was about possibility. So as a child, you know, because we're talking about, you know, the almost 50, but, you know, we were chanting the 20s and, you know, the 21 and 22, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Growing up, and it was a completely different world. What it gives you is possibility because none of us knew that it was possible for us to come here. So when your country is developing so much, how much are you going to develop by default, even if you're the laziest person on earth?
You're talking about opportunities as well here.
Right, right. And so you're gonna keep going forward because that's just where the ship is going, even if you're the laziest on earth. So our biggest underachievers are still doing incredibly well. I was thinking about this.
Wow!
I did an event for National Day a couple days ago in for
tech company.
A government. No, it was like a government thing in Abu Dhabi. And I was thinking about this, and I said, you know what? This was a horrible year globally, but when you start thinking about what we did, I'm like, wait, we had 2-week lockdown. We had curfew for a month.
Yeah.
We've been living life incredibly. As an artist, as a performer, I've been performing live since July.
Yeah.
To like to proper right. audiences, mm. and the first event we did together because
was that
remember
it? Really AI. That was the yeah wow World AI Trade everything wow.
that was yeah. that was the first the event in Dubai right
that's yeah. crazy
and then you know we went to Mars this year like
bro you're saying it yes. like man
what continues
I think yeah. you make
we were laughing we're like that was a good idea bro like yeah that was a good timing yeah. go no, yalla, take listen. Us all we'll go to yeah. Mars
if this is our worst year. Bro.
Bring it on.
Right.
Bro, our right. best years yeah. are, you yeah. know, yeah. you appreciate them for sure.
I love that. I love
Alhamdulillah,
that.
We, you know, this what if you think about it, this mm. year was incredible if you're from or live here.
Wow. I mean, drop amazing the mic right answer. There. Yeah, we're nearly ending the hour, but, you know, we kind of want to give you the last few minutes. Sorry for that. Yeah, just vibing hey. Here. We like to vibe. We'd like to give you the last few minutes if you want to say anything to anyone who's tuning in. You know, just one minute. Go ahead, Mina Liccione.
Ali, you got anything?
No, you. I got something, but...
You take it. Go ahead.
All right, if you're listening and yeah. you've been thinking about doing something for many years and you haven't mm-hmm. done it, stop thinking, start doing, listen. We were just having this conversation yesterday, you know, recessions are good, you know, or tough times are good because it helps you get out there. And I also want to give a huge shout out for Pulse 95. For having Arabs presenting as well. Yeah. I love God you, bless. So I'm not yeah. saying you should.
I'll just get my coat.
No, you don't have Arab presenters yeah. on the radio, yeah, and I appreciate Pulse yeah. 95 yeah. for doing amazing. That. And of course, true. You got one of our best.
Yo, my man, you know, this is for you, bro. Come on, yo.
Oh! Ali, say it. Hey!
Sons of Yusuf. Mina Liccione.
Yeah, yeah.
This is the music that Ali kind of walks on, which is really,
yes,
really cool and incredible.
Yo, I met Yagu when he was 17 years old.
Wow.
That was insane.
Man, just a few seconds until the headlines. Mina Liccione, Ali Asseya, thank you so much for blessing
thank
us today.
Thank you so much.
Happy 49th National Day. Go follow them. Their handles is on our Instagram, on Pulse 95 Radio. The video will be up tomorrow, hopefully on YouTube. Shout out to you, Ali, for always believing in me and giving me great vibes. And Mina Liccione, you mean the world to me. You've pushed me in many ways. We've had incredible discussions about me and my son and the family. So God bless you, sis. Really incredible. So
God bless
make
you
some
too.
Noise one more time.
Thank
for
you
Ali
so
saying,
much.
Mina Liccione.
Thank you.
We will be right back. Keep it locked. Pulse 95 Radio.
Yalla Home with Ella Schofield and Big Hass.
Shout out, Ray.
Shout out, Ray. Yeah, just saying, hey, Ray, it's 20 to 8, and we are, of course, live. For the next 3 days, we are live. Actually, we have one yesterday, so it's today and tomorrow.
We're always live.
We're always live. We're here for you, giving you the most incredible shows full of guests. Obviously, I think Yalla Home's the best because it's full of musicians, artists, comedians, actors, producers, and musicians. Did I say musicians?
Yeah, no, 100%. You know, I actually want to kind of, as we're ending the show, I just want to talk about what Ali said at the end.
Yeah.
A couple of things, Anna, that he said, and I want to thank Pulse 95 Radio for giving us a platform like this, because he said it. It's not me.
Right.
He said it.
Right.
Two things. One thing he said about that, thank you for Pulse for showing Arab presenters that Arabs can also be on the radio.
He did say that.
And that came from him. That's not me. I know I get bored with people talking all day. They get bored of me, like, all talking like that. But
no,
this is coming from him.
You know, you've got a point. And I get where you're coming from.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
So that's one. And then two, what he said about supporting people. This is coming from a stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
Also,
and I was fascinated by this. I kept asking him more questions about it, didn't I? Because I just wanted to understand. But he did. He talked about it passionately.
Yeah, it's the same thing with music, by the way. He said it beautifully. Rami is an incredible Egyptian American actor. He won awards. But when he won, it's like you give. When I said flowers, you give him your dues when they win outside.
Yeah.
And this is a big problem, Anna. Seriously, I know this is a drive time show, but this is one point that we need to figure it out. And the fact that he said it, it's a problem. It's not because he made it in the West that he's like you have to from within, from here.
But obviously, culturally, the Arab world feels that the barometer is making it in the Western world.
That's what he was saying. Yeah. He was saying once we make it out there, the Arab region...
Then suddenly they pay attention.
And it has nothing to do with the West right here. I'm not attacking the West. I'm saying the Arabs, we need to show love and we need to show support.
Yeah.
So when he said those two points, I was like, wow. So proud to be on Pulse 95, obviously breaking barriers in its own way.
Yeah.
We got Arab presenters, non-Arab presenters, and it's just really nice to hear somebody say, like, and speak a little bit of Arabic and even pronounce the words
correctly. Yeah,
and again, not attacking the brothers and sisters who everyone is doing work, everyone has to work, but it was something always in the UAE and a little bit in Saudi Arabia as well, but a different dialect, that it's nice to hear an Arabic accent in a way. Even
and
if
I
it's
do
like
agree
a,
with you. Look, I live in an Arabic world. This is your country, you know. And much as I love it, I don't speak the language.
Mm-hmm.
And
you're doing well, though. You're speaking good.
Thank you. But the other thing, if I can jump in on it, because I agree with everything that you and Ali said, but from my point of view, mm-hmm. I was put on air with an Arab. That doesn't happen either, Hass.
Yeah.
So on the radio, I've been here for 10 years.
100%.
I've been in radio for 10 years here and in the UK. No one put me on air with an Arab.
Yeah.
I was put on air with other Westerners, whether they be Irish, Scottish, I'm trying to think.
Americans,
Australians.
British.
No one put me on air with an Arab. Pulse 95 did. Mm. You know, Sharjah Broadcasting Authority did. And that's what they've done. They've merged
the cultures.
That's
how you break it, by the way.
That's how
How
you
many
do.
Things I've learned about London, UK, England through you. How many things have you learned about the region, Islam, through me?
Oh, ridiculous.
But it's
what
the same
I've
bridge.
Learned.
And that's what
it's
I'm
incredible.
Saying. It's the same thing. I've learned too.
Yeah.
So it is that bridge that we have. And we're talking like this, of course, today, 2nd of December, celebrating the 49th National Day in the UAE. We've had an incredible day today. And I think it's like one of those days where, I love what I do. This is the reason.
I had that feeling too. Yeah. Well, it makes you reflective anyway, because there's a celebratory feel. National Day is celebratory and it is flags. And you know, you have a passion for flags.
Mm.
It makes you feel very loyal.
Yeah.
But yesterday, as obviously all the National Day stuff started coming up on social media and being around, and that, you know, there were flags everywhere, it makes me patriotic.
Yeah.
But only because I've been here since the 39th.
Crazy, right?
You know, and when I do the reflection on that.
Celebrating the 39th UAE National Day, you were here.
I was here. Now I'm doing my 49th.
Dope.
And it is. It's like one of those, wow, you know, I'm here.
You've
this
seen
is
it.
Me.
Ali was talking about that. He's talking about like the evolution of it, how this country and every emirate is different and it's coming up its own way. I loved how Mina as well was kind of showing love and supporting, and also, you know, she... Like, I didn't want to say that when she was like with us, but you know, me and Mina had really incredible discussions, especially about Ahmed, my son. When we came here, they did it. They were part of a movie that was talking about autism, and we went on and about. Was maybe our first event, me, my wife, and my son.
Right.
And Ahmed was actually attending this movie that talks about autism.
Wow.
And she was there. I think her sister was there. It was really nice. And ever since, it was like, you know, and of course I know her before I even joined in here, and it's that passion for hip hop and maybe American culture and just, you know, New York, and it's just really incredible to see both of them do what they do.
I love the interaction between them as well. You know, there's and that's why I was obviously honest about that from the off. I wanted to know about two performers together, married, performing together, working together. You know, I'm completely, because my parents also were in the same industry.
Yeah.
I was burnt so badly by the rows on the, you know, the dinner table, and it was comedy. And we used to pick holes in my parents and go, "Will you stop?" But they don't have that. You know, they're very
yeah, they
gelled,
seem like best friends, and you know,
friends.
It's just also like kind of playing with each other or using each other in a way that's
completely,
really cool.
Completely, they know each other inside
really
out.
Really cool.
Yeah, lovely.
Today has been really great. We've had AY, the producer, Ayham, who produced a lot of incredible hits throughout for the region and is trying to develop a sound. Could be a little bit on the Western international vibe more. And I really wait for him to develop also his sound in the region over here even more.
Yeah.
Which is really just fantastic. And tomorrow is also another incredible
day.
We do have
bumper
stand-up
show.
Comedy as well in the building tomorrow.
I'm dragging all the comedians in. Love it, love it, love it. So we've got Ima tomorrow. Now, I've seen Ima perform 3 times, 4 times in the last 6 months. Very, very funny. And Mina and Ali talked about how much they love her. She also hosts quite a lot of their shows. So they work a lot with Ima, but Ima's just finished a huge solo show, which was a complete sellout, and she's Filipino.
Mm.
And for me,
she
just tells the jokes that you want. You want the Filipino too. You know, you said that Ali is breaking barriers and telling it like it is, and they obviously have the cultural thing, Mina and Ali. Well, I feel Ima does that too. And she had my kids in fits of hysterics when we went to see her
That's
as well.
So funny.
And that was also interesting for me, that teenagers were loving her work. So that'll be fun.
Also have Chris from the SPAA. He's going to be joining us.
Chris Gold. Now, he is head of acting at Sharjah Performing Arts Academy, and he's going to be talking about what it's like working here. You know, obviously the growth of Sharjah Performing Arts Academy, the growth of the staff, the growth of the students, and this is the ruler here at Sharjah. It's his project, the Performing Arts Academy, and the first of its kind in the region. But Chris Gold is from the UK, and they brought him over to be the head of acting. Wonderful guy, and that'll be an interesting chat, that one.
We're also going to have a chat with Hamid Al-Tai, who's an Emirati composer, pianist. We've had him on the show before, yeah. I think it was through lockdown. That was really an interesting convo. But then we're going to have him again, and he's going to be talking to us about all sort of things, how he has been in the past 5-6 months since we last chatted with him. But yeah, we love you guys. We always say we salute you.
If you liked this episode of Yalla Home, drop a like and subscribe. 95. Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.